I'm Edith Lukawe. I'm the director of Home of Hope. Home of Hope has run for, it's now 6 years. It started in 2007, July. The Home of Hope started through God blessing me with my own son, Derek, who is a disabled. So that's how I was inspired after I was neglected by my family and the family of my husband. Everyone was like, I brought a curse in the family. It was really hard for me because everyone had to abandon us and we were just living as a family, me and my husband and my children. So through that, I found that it's really hard to stay with a child with disability. And I was inspired when I looked at other children, when other parents, their husbands abandoned them and left them in the house. I got that heart of setting up Home of Hope for children who are abandoned and who are orphans.
How far I've fallen, still I know that you love me too.
Place is that I didn't really know what to expect, and so going there it was quite shocking to see how disabled the kids actually were, and a lot of them were struggling with quite immense disabilities, and that was really hard to see. I struggled to find see any love in the place or see where God was in the place, because the kids were just so disabled and in so much pain, but looking around, but as I learnt more about the place, I realised that it was just a place of love.
We thank God that we were able to get our permanent place. We are no longer renting, as we were struggling behind paying the rent and sending us the house. So right now we have our permanent house. Children have got wheelchairs, someone donated wheelchairs for them. Right now those are the highlights we have.
Yeah.
Things which God has blessed us in 2003. We thank God for this community because they felt so much touched. They came to welcome us. Everyone had to bring some small thing like beans, avocados, pawpaw, jackfruit. They really welcomed us well, because at first we thought maybe no one will like us at the village as we are new. But they all welcomed us and thanked us the work we are doing.
Beautiful.
And they were so grateful that they had to praise God for this work. I've got 35 children and then 16 staff. Occupational therapist, I have physiotherapist, I have the nannies who are taking care of the children, then the cook, and those ones who clean the compound, and the security guard.
My light would have to be the Home of Hope, which was a home where these disabled kids who were abandoned were there, and these carers took after them, and that really impacted me a lot. Yeah, it just showed how even though those kids aren't theirs, they can just keep giving and giving and giving without anything in return, but they do get a lot in return, if that makes sense.
Tony was not able to walk by the time they brought Tony. Tony's parents died, and the person who was taking care of Tony could just lock him inside. He couldn't even allow Tony to eat with, share food with some of her children. So the neighbor heard about Home of Hope, and he contacted me to help Tony. By the time they brought Tony, I didn't expect Tony to reach as he is right now. He was not able to sit, to do anything, or to feed himself. But it's now a year. Tony was, through our exercise, which the therapists are doing, he was able to walk. He can feed himself. We are even teaching him to talk, and he can even go to school. Because when you tell him answer this, he can say it out.
Yeah.
So we are working on his speech. He can call mom, he can all call all the names, and even he understands everyone's name and the bed where each and everyone sleeps.
Yeah.
That is very great and awesome. I thank God for that.
Oh,
when I was there, one of the ladies, she like brought this boy over. I was just playing with a few of the kids, and one of the workers like brought this kid over to me, and I was just holding him, and every like 2 or 3 minutes he'd have like an epileptic fit, and there was nothing I could do to stop it, and he was screaming pain every like 2 or so minutes, and it just like broke my heart because there was nothing that I could do to stop it, and there was nothing that could be done to stop it, yet it would continually happen. And I guess like I didn't really know what to think, because there was just so much pain like in this one little boy. He was only 3 or 4. And I guess I was just thankful for what I had, what I have, but then again I was thinking, why am I so blessed? And I guess I've struggled with that a little bit, to think, well, why am I so blessed? Like, why am I a healthy white person that has a family that is able to, you know, have the money to come here and like all the rest of it? So I guess I've really struggled with that in terms of, yeah, and knowing what that means for me also. It's like, because I am so blessed, what does that then mean? What do I have to do? What's my obligation?
That I have seen, I am responsible. Faith without deeds is dead.
Yeah, we are praying for more support for Home of Hope so that we can be able to achieve our activities. Yeah, whenever we can't say that we need money in a lump sum, but whatever small, even if it's $20, even if it's $100, whatever someone feel on his or her heart to support, I call for more support for these children. Yeah. Children are still coming in Home of Hope. The government is referring children, because Home of Hope is the only organization taking care of children with disabilities. As right now we don't have enough support, and it's hard when they bring a child in a bad condition, we can't send out that child. So we call our brothers and sisters to help these children so that they can also enjoy the world as we are doing. So we pray for their health, for the strength for us, favor upon them and favor upon us. Because without favor with them, I think the staff can get tired. So yeah. We need prayer. Yeah, we need much prayer for their health, for the provision, for the staff, so that God can keep on strengthening us and giving us love for them.
Show, show, show.
Ready?
Oh. Ah, hello!
Hello!
Hello.